There you go, hit it. There you go. Keep it moving, mate. Keep it moving.
Game on.
When you're all packed up and heading off on a fishing trip that you've been planning for months, this is not what you want to hear.
In the news at 8, Auckland wakes up to a city hit by a once-in-a-decade storm. Gusts of 200 kilometres an hour overnight have caused havoc, with many roofs lifting, trees falling and waves swamping coastal roads. Lightning strikes damaged 12 houses on Whangaparoa Peninsula. Severe conditions are expected to last through the weekend, and the New Zealand Transport Agency is urging travellers to take extreme care at all times.
Well, in spite of the forecast, we are still looking forward to an excellent trip. We've got an experienced crew, we've picked the weather window so we can get across to the sanctuary of Great Barrier Island. We're always going to be able to find a lee shore and somewhere to fish. And we've got a couple of fellas who have won a competition to come fishing with us who are particularly keen to get there. We've got Thomas, and he's brought along with him his old man Grant. But that doesn't complete our crew, because once we get to Great Barrier Island, we've got a couple of very special guests that are going to be fishing with us at the fishing mecca of Great Barrier Island. Well, here we are, Great Barrier Island, and this lovely sheltered sanctuary is Port Fitzroy. Haven for plenty of boaties to get out of that rugged wind and weather. And just before we go and pick up our special guests, we've just got about an hour or so to kill, so we might throw out the anchor in this calm water, see if we can't rustle up a few fish. Beautiful looking snapper baits right there. Yeah, keep winding up there, Grant. I've got something for you. Just bring us your top hook. Okay, I'm putting a live bait on this. Yeah, on this top hook. And our most likely outcome from this is a John Dory, which is pretty special. So the trick is, if you feel it's something, grab. Don't give it the big old strike for a John Dory.
Okay.
Yeah. Just let it sort of load down, and then just wind tight, and that should just pull the hook into the corner of his mouth, because they got a real soft mouth. Does our mate, the old Johnny? If it goes screaming off, it could be a kingie or a big snapper. You got him? Just get the hang of using your rod as opposed to a winch, because you'll get away with it with a little fish when you get the old big one on. That's when you'll be wanting to use your newfound angling skills.
Oh,
no way.
John Dory, get the net, there's that live bait. What did I tell you? We'll chuck a live. I love it when a plan comes together, eh? Cool. Hey? Just slide it over towards the net, slide it into the net. You beauty. Hey? Yep, not bad. And you hear that noise he's making? They actually make an audible noise, does the John Dory. Yeah, I would go as far as to tell you what he's saying, because I can speak John Dory-ish. But it's a G-rated show, so I can't actually say what he's calling you at the moment. It's a nice Johnny too.
So what's with the spot on them? Was that a fake eye for predators?
Yeah, in biblical terms, they call it the thumbprint of St. John. It's actually, believe it or not, for prey. It's to confuse the prey. So what he's doing, Grant, is he's swimming along like this, okay? And you can tell by his tail and his build, he's not the most powerful and speedy fish going around as the old mate, the John Dory. He's not like a tuna that can, or a kingfish that can track down and catch out of pure speed and power a bait fish. So he relies on stealth. In fact, so that slim profile, he can slink through the weeds, and in fact he'll even roll himself on his side. As he turns sort of side on, that there will give the illusion to a bait fish that the eye is looking somewhere else, and then pow. He shoots out that telescopic mouth and inhales his prey. And they have just a beautiful, delicate flesh. No scales, and I prefer to fry them up with the skin on and eat the skin. I tell you what the best sound a John Dory makes is, sizzle, sizzle, my nizzle. All right, we've got our John Dory. Time to go pick up our guests. and make a plan, a serious fishing plan. Well, we've arrived here at Port Fitzroy. It's on Auckland's doorstep, but really, it could be a million miles away. It's a special place. Here they are, flown in direct from training. Simon, how are you, mate?
Good, good.
How was training, all right?
Can't complain.
Yeah.
Glad to be out here, though.
Yeah, look, you get here for a bit of relaxing and we've got a camera in your face straight away.
Hey,
Nathan, Matt.
Yeah, team,
good. Good. Nice to meet you, mate. When Lion Red said they were sending Simon Mannering in a hooker, we were expecting something a little bit different, eh? Yeah, sorry. There you go, hit it. There you go. Keep it moving, mate. Keep it moving. Game on.
We're at Great Barrier Island with a couple of the Vodafone Warriors. And after making plans overnight in the shelter of Port Fitzroy, it's now time to limber up and head out to the open coast to see what fish we can find.
Well, the grand plans we made last night for a crack of dawn start were scuppered. And hand on heart, we were up at 5 o'clock this morning ready to go. However, the 40 knots of wind howling around our ears made us stay on anchor and have a cooked breakfast. But right now, we've just plucked up the courage to poke our nose out of Port Fitzroy, work our way up the west coast of Great Barrier Island and around to hopefully some shelter on the eastern coast. Where the anchor's going down, we're going to burly up a storm. That's the plan. Well, while the conditions have scuppered a lot of our plans, it hasn't prevented us coming around to the sheltered side of the island. Well, at least relatively sheltered. We've anchored up in the lee of the island. Of course, whenever we anchored up, we've got our burley. We're not travelling around looking for fish, dropping baits, so we're relying on the fish to come to us. Hence, our king salmon burley.
Big bait, big fish.
It's the theory. Whether it works, we'll find out.
Oh, nice bait presentation. A little bit of finesse you're showing there, Simon.
Slow start, but very slow. Starting to pick up a little bit, but hopefully good things to come.
What do you say to Marshall, the troops, when there's a slow start?
Stick with it, boys.
There you go, mate.
Have you got target?
We won't claim this one just yet, though.
Oh, look at that, mate. Takes the Aussie to catch the first snapper. You know, over in Aussie, you guys would be celebrating. You'd probably get that mounted and put on the wall in Aussie. That would be like a trophy bream. Oh, it's a oh, look at that bream. Of course, it's probably worth noting while I'm doing this and intend to release it, that I've got a wet hand, which is obviously much better for the fish. It reduces the amount of their protective coating that comes off. And as you saw, he swam away happy. I could tell he was happy, his tail was wagging.
Yes, that's Scotty. Yep. Gun ran around in circles.
Trevor, I thought it was. The way the old rod tip was banging away, that could be our sashimi for tonight then, boys. Well, here we go. Here, tug.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, this is a nice snapper, boy.
Really got picked up, mate. This is what I was thinking. Oh, I was trying to go to ground. I'm only on 8 kg line too, so I haven't got real heavy gear with the snags the boys have been getting.
I might have actually got away from the bottom. Maybe he wasn't swimming towards us. Maybe I'm dragging him towards us because he's not as big as I thought.
Got the adrenaline rush though when he picked up that bait. But I'm picking him for a snapper anyway. And it's nice when you turn up on a spot, get a bit of burley going, and you feel that real buzz of a hard and fast take I use on a fish. And even at that size, I really have to work to get them away from the reef. There we go. That's a little bit more like it. That's a little bit more like it. See, they do exist. Oh God, I spend that much time going snapper schmapper. Geez, for the last 10 minutes I've been going
Jeez, I was about to trade in my last 5 marlin for one. Beautiful coppery coloured fish living in here in the kelp. And you'll notice the rig, just the lightest sinker, just enough to sort of weight it, get it floating down there naturally, cast at the back of the burley trail. And here's the gear I caught him on. Beautiful gear. It's a Talica 8, 8kg line. A pleasure to use. There you go, hit it. There you go. Keep him moving, mate, keep him moving. Oh, has he gone to ground, has he? They'll go for that weed.
Nah, I think he's
gone to ground, mate. Here, tighten up and see if you can just give it some short pumps of the rod and see if you can drag him out of that weed. So there's definitely a fish that picked that up, and the big ones will go to ground like that. The odds are stacked pretty highly against you actually getting this fish once they get into that kelp. Yeah, if you actually hold your hand over the spool like that, yeah, so it can't spin. Yeah, you might just wind down a little bit. Oh, you got it. Nice. No,
well, now that it's broken, okay. I can tell you it was probably about 25 pounds.
The weather has prevented us from getting to the best spots, and we're restricted to fishing in a small sheltered area. But a steady flow of our king salmon burley is pulling in enough fish to keep us entertained.
Premature.
And we're starting to see just how competitive these guys are. And the Trans-Tasman rivalry is kicking off.
Taking candy from a baby. Go the Aussies.
The camera away, baby.
We've got a scoreboard on the telly. Someone got a count.
These old friendies feeding the family. Mine's going hungry.
Simon is determined to catch a bigger snapper than Nathan. But things just aren't going his way. And at the moment, not even the seagulls are safe.
Did you get it? Well, while these conditions really aren't ideal for fishing, it's a bitterly cold southerly blowing. What I can do is jump in and see what I can find, and if I see anything, hopefully you guys will get to see it too.
The long swim,
but as is the case, it's always worthwhile going for a wee swim. Got us our 10 power.
We're far out and it's freezing cold too.
Oh, he's got him this time. You're just not giving them a chance. That's domination.
Oh, shark. Yeah.
What's that?
Kingy.
Kingfish following it. Okay. Oh yeah, well done, friendy. Well done, well done.
David Chew, mate.
Ah. Yeah, just watch that rod going high. The base of the rod wants to only go to about here with these graphite rods. There you go, good result. Oh, and still got a fish on there, how's that?
Yeah!
Now that's special.
Look at that, eh?
Best story of my life.
There you go.
Dave! This is a f***ing massive one. Holy s***. No, I don't know if I've even got a show on this line, mate. This is a massive fish. It's a massive snapper, mate. Please. Please. Far out. That line's smoking, mate. I don't know if you can see that real from there, but yeah, it's a real big fish, mate. I'm pushing this 8 kilo line to the max, really, as much as I can really give it. I'm thinking it could be a shark. Mate, that was smoking. Although you think a shark might have bitten through the lead trace by now. Gonna have to go for a run up the front, I think. Going over around the outside of the anchor, I hope. I hope there might be a kingie going around the anchor. They're smoking off again now. Oh, if that was a snapper, it was gonna be huge. Oh, heading back down that way. Could be a bloody kingie, maybe. Look, this has got a bit of a crowd up the front here, a few spectators.
Love you, man.
Look, grey or silver to you? Yeah, it might be a kingie. Excuse me, guys. Oh, don't go back up the front again, roll around. Well, that's better than a shark. Well, it's, I was like, oh, it's not a snapper, damn, it's a shark. To, oh, well, something in between, a kingie.
Seen any kingfish before, mate?
No. No, I haven't had the privilege to catch any.
Okay, just take your time, mate. Yeah, he's only just hooked too, mate, so take, just. Got him. Yep. Okie doke. Lift him on in. And that is a nice sort of a way to round out our day, gents. A few fresh kingfish steaks to take home. Look at the beautiful colours on them. And caught on this. Fast becoming my new favourite. The Talica 8, 8kg line. Beauty, boys. Well, we'll dispatch this fella. And tataki, man. Beautiful, mate. Beautiful. I might even go as far to cook his up a little bit. My shout, boys.
A lot of the gear and techniques in this episode have changed. And of course, we've had countless more fishing adventures. So to catch up with the latest tips and techniques, as well as our latest fishing action, check out ultimatefishing.tv and download the Ultimate Fishing app. So wherever you go, you've got access to our entire catalogue of tips, rigs, techniques, and location information. And it's all available free at ultimatefishing.tv.